This is CHS TV News.
Good morning, Cathedral. I'm Andrea.
And I'm Lily with your morning announcements for Wednesday, February 22nd.
Let's start off with the show with a message from Ms. McCabe.
Good morning, and what a great day to be a Gale. As we begin our Lenten journey today as a Catholic community, we're reminded to repent and follow the gospel. Today also happens to be the days commemorated across Canada and other parts of the world, Pink Shirt Day. Pink Shirt Day reminds us that we are against any type of bullying. And so even those of you who are not wearing a pink shirt today, you're reminded that this is an important part of us being a Catholic community, that we stand up for one another and we're there for one another. So what that means is if someone says, oh, I'm gonna like talk to that person and I'm gonna let them know what I think, you don't go with your phone and record all of this, a private conversation between two people who are trying to figure out their differences. That's bullying. We want to make sure that everyone knows and understands that when we set ourselves apart from someone by putting someone down, that that's not who we are. That's when we're trying to exert control, and that's when we need to maybe reach out and find out why we're feeling the way we are, in that we're, you know, trying to put down someone, some other person. I can tell you from my own experience, I was bullied and I was a bully. And I learned from both of those experiences. And as a bully, I learned that I didn't even know that I was bullying, but I was hitting someone every day. And finally the person said to me, I was in grade 9, person said to me, why do you hurt me every day? I'm like, what are you talking about? She said, you're nothing but a bully. I was like, oh my gosh. I didn't even realize until that moment how I was using my size, my voice, my punch to control another person and to put them down. So that was a big learning opportunity for me. So as Ms. O'Keefe said, Lent is a time for reflection. So reflect on who you want to be. And remember, we do have an anti-bullying tool. It is the anonymous bullying tool. You can find it on our school's website. If you witness bullying, if you've been bullied, or you're a bully and you want help, you can fill out this form and we will get the help to the right people. So please consider that as we enter our time of reflection and our Lenten journey, because anti-bullying starts with you, it starts with me, and it starts with owning what we've done, taking responsibility for it, and always trying to do better. And that's really our Lenten journey, owning what we've done and trying to do better. That's the reflection. So Gales, you will be called down by class. There is a seating plan. Mr. Valeri is sending out a revised plan, so teachers, just ask you to check your email to make sure you're sitting in the right spot. And have yourself a great Cathedral Day. See you all soon. Here's Student Council with some big news. Always big news from Student Council.
Thank you. Good morning, Cathedral. I'm Fayez with three athletes of the week. Our first athlete is Araya Honiventeros, who won first place at GHAC in the 100-meter individual medley, which automatically qualifies her for OFSA. Also from the swim team, Michael Kazarak clocked in at 1:30.39, 6 seconds faster than his personal best time for his 100-meter individual medley. He always models positive team spirit. Finally, Gutu Ali'i from the junior boys basketball team is our last athlete of the week. Gatou contributes offensively by scoring each game and defensively by stopping the other team's best player from scoring. He hustles and competes in each game and encourages his teammates. Well done, Gales. That's all from me. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Faez. Graduates that wish to be considered as valedictorian for this year's graduation are asked to pick up a purple self-nomination form and guidance. Please read the requirements carefully and get your speech ready for the pre-selection process. Speaking of graduates, all grade 12 students who intend to graduate this June are reminded that the first list of names of potential graduates is posted on the bulletin board outside of guidance. You must be in a position to meet all the graduation requirements in order to be in the list, which include 30 credits, literacy, and 40 volunteer hours. Please see Ms. Ferrasso if you have any questions.
Option sheets for September will be coming soon. Consider taking co-op. Not sure what co-op is all about? Take a look.
Have you heard about co-op but aren't really sure what it is? Co-op is a hands-on learning experience that allows you to apply to 2 co-op credits towards your compulsory high school graduation requirements. You should take co-op to gain valuable work experience to help build your resume. It'll help you develop knowledge, skills, and attitudes needed to be successful in the future. If you have questions or like to sign up for co-op, see your guidance counselor.
Welcome back. All students that are attending the New York City trip that your permission forms and rooming lists are due by Friday. Thanks for Mr. Walker.
On March 21st, Girl Guides will be hosting the Cuts for Cancer event. This event aims to raise cancer awareness, and all hair donated will be sent to Wigs for Kids to manufacture wigs for cancer patients in need. Hair donations must be a minimum of 12 inches per organization's requirements, and all participating students will be given a free haircut, hair wash, and will have their hair styled by a professional hairstylist the day of. For anyone interested in participating, sign-up sheets and further details will be posted by the end of the week outside room 328 and with additional information on hair requirements.
The annual CHSY Dodgeball Tournament takes place on March 10th in our gym. The tournament is a fundraiser activity for the Annex, so each player will be required to pay $2 to participate. You must select a team of 10 players with at least 2 grade 9s and a minimum of 2 girls. Please pick up a registration form today outside of room 328. Registration closes at the end of the day on March 3rd. Please remember that you need to have less than 6 absences this semester to participate, and each team must have a team captain.
This message is for any student interested in writing the upcoming University of Waterloo Math Contest. Please sign up in the math office in room 319. Thanks for Mr. Chafe.
There will be a senior boys soccer tryout today outside on the field. Please bring both indoor and outdoor attire for training. Thanks from Coach D'Ambrosio.
Attention members of the junior boys basketball team. Your team pizza party will be Tuesday, February 28th after school in room 216. Thanks from Ms. Pinto.
Any students wishing to play senior boys football next season, please note that there is a training session in our gym today from 3:30 to 5 p.m. And speaking of football, any grade 9s interested in playing junior football next season, please come to room 206 to sign up and recover information on upcoming training sessions. Thank you for Mr. Susie.
Attention all Cathedral badminton players. There will be a badminton club practice tomorrow, right after school in the gym. Please bring appropriate footwear and attire for practice. We will need lots of help setting up, so be prepared and be on time. Looking forward to seeing everyone there. Thanks from the coaches.
And those are all of your announcements for today, Cathedral.
Please note that Mrs. DeMusia's classes are canceled today, and all students involved in today's liturgy are asked to report to the gym at this time.
Have a great day, Gales, and thanks for watching.